treatment for bleeds in hemophilia has been around now for about 30 to 40 years. Before that, there really was no therapy that existed, and patients who would get bleeds, their joints would usually swell up and it would be very, very painful. The consequences of that would be that they would destroy their joints at young ages, and by the time that these children would be adolescents or adults, they were often quite crippled.
Once I've determined that I do have a bleed, then go about getting the factor. Once you get it, then you mix it, and then you do an infusion.
Patients with hemophilia are missing factor, so we can simply give them factor. At least for a period of time, they have quite enough factor to stop any bleeding and also to prevent bleeding.
In the blood, there are a bunch of different factors, and they basically help out the platelets that clot the blood. So they basically form like a spider web type thing, and it enables the clot to form properly.
So it has to be given through an intravenous, put into a vein, and then it lasts for a few days, but it will disappear.
Most people do home infusions now, like you can do it yourself or have a parent do it. Sometimes you might come to the hospital to have it done.
I learned to self-infuse at Camp Wanakita.
At camp, that was the main part when I started learning. Every day I'd do an infusion myself. The nurses were like extremely helpful. That was basically what got me started in infusing myself.
I was extremely nervous, but I did it, and I was really happy.
Was it scary? Like, the first time, yeah, I was definitely nervous, because I've seen the times where you've went in and you've missed the vein completely and you'd have to pull it out and put it right back in, and I didn't like that part at all. But after a couple times, a few times, you get used to it, the nerves go away and you're able to do it.
Many patients, and particularly those with severe disease, actually receive factor on a regular basis to prevent any bleeds from happening. And the majority of patients with hemophilia do very well when they're on this type of preventive therapy, which we call prophylaxis.
The levels of factor in my blood is 4%. A regular person can be like 170%. So when you go from that to 4, you can really see like the difference. And then people that are more severe is like less than 1.
In every sense, no, with prophylaxis, we are turning our boys with severe hemophilia, those with less than 1% factor, 8 or 9, into moderate hemophilia, where they bleed infrequently.
Before I do any sports or anything now, I try to get an infusion so I won't get it badly hurt.
Now that we have safe products, it's about prevention. It's about doing things to prevent bleeds. Over 80% of persons in the world with hemophilia are either undiagnosed or have very limited access to factor concentrates.
In the past, patients with hemophilia, unfortunately, particularly in the 1980s, were exposed to a number of viruses such as HIV and hepatitis, and back then that was the most feared complication of having hemophilia, but that really is a thing of the past and it's no longer something that is seen at all.
So if I could do one thing across the globe, I would ask that all persons with hemophilia had full and equal access to safe factor concentrates, because I think that's the most crucial thing right now. Because if you have that, you can treat, you can take away pain, you can do surgery, you can prolong life, you can do all of the things that we've come to take for granted here.